Marathons are very, very important. You know, they are very political in nature. You know, cities like New York City, where they have done marathons before, Miami, Philadelphia, rely on marathons as a revenue earner, particularly New York City and all over the world. So political decisions are necessary for successful marathons. But I'm talking to the media today, and I want to ask if there's anybody within the media sitting here who's ever done a marathon before. Only one person. So two, all right. I have done 8 marathons before, now, and including the Lagos Marathon, a year 2017, yes. And my experience was amazing. But what I found out was that, yes, the coverage the marathon got was inadequate. And it was because the journalists first did not understand. A lot of journalists I met on the way did not understand the course. They didn't know where we were running through. The only place they knew was the Third Milan Bridge. After that, they had no idea. So it's important that you know the course of the marathon, where we're starting from and where we're ending. The second aspect of it is equipment. You know, I also did not see a lot of journalists who had the right equipment for the marathon. When you are chasing after someone who is running, you cannot be using conventional camera. You have to use things that are digital and that you can catch up with them. I ran a marathon in New York and also covered it for myself. I had a camera on my wrist. Most of you don't have that. And you also have to be fit and agile as a journalist to be able to cover a marathon. So there should have been a training before now that makes it possible for you also to train for the marathon, even if it is to just make sure that you can catch up with the runners. Because there's a lot to cover in the marathon. One other thing that I didn't see happen is that we didn't cover, in the one that I attended, the people who made the marathon. They are not the runners. They are the people who are watching on the sidelines everywhere you go. And by nature of that, you find out the diversity of supporters. You know, you find out that people who are running and covering and sharing in, you know, on the Ikorodu Road are different from when you get on the Third Milan Bridge, where we were physically almost mobbed by area boys. You know, and this is very true. The other thing I found is inadequate security for the Lagos Marathon, especially after you leave the areas that are popular. And this coverage was also not there, because journalists were even afraid of certain. There were black spots on the marathon the last time. One was Oroshoki, and immediately after you leave the Third Milan Bridge, there were some boys there who were mobbing people if they could. Another thing I saw was the fact that wherever there was inadequacy of, you know, hydration, apart from the Third Milan Bridge, you could not find cold water. And I asked one of the organizers, why don't you use cold water? They said a doctor advised against it. If you are running at 27 degrees centigrade and you can't get cold water to cool yourself, then you are going to kill people. That's the truth. So you want to make sure that you are not only covering what the marathon organizers are asking you to cover, but the frauds of the marathon, so that they can improve on a yearly basis. There are over 20,000 participants. I don't know how many people are participating this year. But you find out that there are over 50,000 who are watching and following. That's a huge amount of participation from both runners and spectators that you cannot afford to leave out. So this was my experience running the Lagos Marathon in 2017. But in other places that I've done it, I also discovered that journalists also are very clinical in determining which of the causes are difficult, which ones are flat. I didn't see that in the coverage that happened in 2000 and subsequent ones and after that. You have to let people understand that when you get to a certain point, it is hard. And these are things that even should come even before the marathon, so that people can be mentally prepared for it. One important thing I should say about marathon is that is one of the races I've ever done in sports that has to do with mental capacity. Because after the 15, 16, 17, and 18th mile, you are pretty much running with your brain, because the entire body is gone. You are out of salt, because you see salt pouring out of your pores, you're losing salt, and then that affects your muscles, and you have muscle cramps. If you're running as well as a journalist and covering this, you need glucose in your pocket on one side and you need salt in case you run out of salt and you have muscle cramps, so that you can catch up with the people who are running. What I need to say finally is that if you're a journalist covering a marathon, you are also running in the marathon. If you are not, then you are not covering the marathon. And running doesn't mean that you'll be physically running. But even if you are on the back of a motorbike, you have to be mentally alert throughout the course of the race to get the best possible coverage for the marathon. And I'm glad that the organizers are starting to arrange on the high table people who look fit. They need to start running marathons themselves, because if you cannot run a marathon, you should not be presiding over marathons.
Anybody who at this point is running for office as president of Nigeria who doesn't recognize the importance of such a great sporting event, need to be invited to understand what it is. That's what I mean. But most importantly, we've had challenges with fitness of our leaders, and maybe a marathon would be a good way to determine who and who is fit, so that we don't end up with a president that will spend more time in London in the next 4 years again.
How do you think this marathon has projected the city in Lagos?
You know, it depends on how, you cannot tell how well it is until the marathon is over. So it's up to them to make it a successful event. I'm excited to hear that about 2,000 people coming from the US. This is a globally uniting event if it's well done. And I hope that the organizers are making it so.